my sophomore year of college, when I was still at Nova, I was gaining a slight interest in it, but I wasn't sure. I was like, nah, I couldn't be a Muslim. I couldn't change my whole life, you know? Yeah, it's a tough thing, and my family would react in a different way.
Being from an Amish Christian household, how tough was it for like you to tell your parents kind of this information?
It was tough. It was very tough.
Welcome everyone to another episode of the Samson and Dallas Show. Your host truly, and we have two special guests with us today. You guys can introduce yourselves.
The name is Abel Samson. I'm currently a student at Virginia Tech, and it's my man's over here.
Introduce yourself, bro.
My name is his man's over here. I'm also a student at Virginia Tech at an unknown location though, in a hood near you.
How y'all doing today?
Man, I'm doing great, bro. I just came back from school. Mm-hmm. Came back to the area. Get to be with my family. Life is good, bro. Alhamdulillah.
How about you?
Everything is good. Alhamdulillah.
Yeah, this guy's a show, bro. But let me get into this with Abel first. And you started doing TikTok a little bit, and I'll put all his content down below. But I want to get into that a little bit. Talk about your journey, why you started doing TikTok creation, and then I have a question for the troll after.
I got you. So basically, I'm just in a stage of life where I just start to realize like the world that we live in, and like how everything, the way that the things that people are taught, I just feel like we're being taught the wrong shit. Mm-hmm. And I don't know. And I also have a like dream for the future, like help people in different countries, start a YouTube channel, vlog my experiences. So I feel like TikTok is like the easiest way to like start off, you know, mm-hmm. get people to know like what I think, what I believe. And yeah, basically.
So, like, basically, talk about a little bit of your content. What type of stuff do you post, like, now?
Cause right now?
Like, 4 videos right now.
Yeah, right now, like, I just started. Like, I'm pretty new to this. So, like, mm-hmm. Basically, like, what was my first videos? First video, I was just, like, I was dead ass just sitting in my basement. And I was dead ass just thinking about life. And I was like, bro, why are people so worried about shit that just does not matter? Mm-hmm. So, I made a video about that. Then, after that, I gained some confidence, started posting other shit, like, I brought up God and how we're in a godless society. Mm-hmm. Everybody's worried about shit that's just so detrimental to our brains. Mm-hmm. Shit like that. So I'm just starting to talk about and just gain more confidence. Shit like that, you know? For sure. And then later down the road, get a little more deep.
Absolutely.
You type shit.
Let me ask you, Wiki. I want to ask you a couple of questions. Like, do you feel like you would ever go into the content creation realm? And like, let the people know a little bit about yourself.
Yeah, for sure. Content creation. Mm. I always wanted to make something as far as like stuff. I don't know. I wanted to make music at a point. I wanted to make.
I remember that.
No, I'm like the greatest rapper ever. Like, I promise you. But like, you know, like because I'm you know, I'm trying to be like on the dean stuff like that, dean things. You know what I'm saying? So I decided not to like pursue that kind of stuff in my life. So one day I would love to like probably do something like this, maybe podcast. I don't know, like just give like Islamic reminders online or whatever. Mm-hmm. But unfortunately for myself, I don't think this is the best time to do stuff like that, just because I feel like if you're going to be like someone who's like pushing like you know this type of content online. Mm-hmm. People will start to look up to you in a way. Even if you don't intend that to happen, people will. And so, I don't want to be a guy who's, like, making Muslim videos. Like, not Muslim videos, but, like...
You know, like, religious videos in general.
Yeah, right? Just giving, like, yeah, religious reminders and stuff online. And then it's like, oh, but, like... You know, like... Bro, you know, like, the Haram police are in the comments. Like, bro, like, what are you doing? Like, bro, come
Facts.
On. Like,
yeah, I'll watch one last time.
I wouldn't say that, but, you know, Haram. But, yeah, basically stuff like that, right? Mm-hmm. So, I wouldn't say I'm, like, the worst person. So, like, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying, like, I want to be, like, my very best self. Like, if I'm going to put myself out there publicly, just because I think that's in the best interest of myself. And
do you feel like that? People. Do you feel like that comes from, like, a confidence issue? Would you say, like, in a sense, like... You're not confident enough in like either your religion or like what you like and like how you move with your faith for you to post that content, or like, you know, but would you give him some advice on that?
Nah, I understand what he's saying, because like, for example, like my feed now is all Islamic stuff, Muslim stuff. Mm-hmm. And in the comments, like if somebody does something like slightly wrong, because I guess people are very like informed about their religion, you know?
Yeah.
if you do something very slightly wrong, they're going to go at you in those comments. So if you're not 100% confident or you know what you're talking about 100%, they're going to go at you. Mm-hmm. So, like, I get what he's saying. Like,
it's not even just that. It's more just, like, for me, it's, like, if you're someone who's making videos, right, on, like, YouTube or TikTok, whatever, giving, like, Islamic, you know, like,
advice or, like, yeah, exactly.
Reminders, advice, whatever, right? It's, like, there's some kid, like, right now who's, like, probably, like, oh, my God, like, dude, I like this guy. He's funny or he's chill or whatever. He's, like, Muslim and stuff, whatever, right? Mm-hmm. And then it's, like, that kid is going to start being, like, he might see my mistake. Someone might see a mistake that I do, right? Mm-hmm. And then they might be, like, that kid will be, like, just not think it's that big of a deal just because, like, I did it and he looks up to me. You see what I'm saying?
No, like, I see what you're trying to say. Like, you're saying, like, you want to be so, like, intact with, like, your faith and whatnot. So when you post that, you know, like, deep down you're not lying to anybody. And yourself, mm-hmm. I feel like that goes with anything as well.
I want to be in a situation where, like, how everything I move, every single way that I move, I wouldn't mind if, like, kids literally looked up to, like, I'm not saying they should. Like, they should look up to, you know, the Prophet Muhammad. I don't know. But, right? But I'm saying, like, if they were to look up to me and, like, you know, like, oh my God, like, they love my YouTube channel and stuff and they look at whatever, right? I'd want to be comfortable knowing that, okay, they're going to normalize everything that I'm doing. Mm-hmm. They're going to think everything I'm doing is okay, right? Mm-hmm. And that is okay because everything I'm doing is literally okay.
So, right? Like, let me now this gets a little bit deeper. Like, what do you feel like you're doing wrong? Like, Anna, what's it called? Anna,
so, as a Muslim, I shouldn't expose myself, so I'm not going to tell you. But, like,
just give us some generalities. Like, just, I guess, a kid in the West and, like, at the age of 21 years old.
When I do plan on doing stuff like that, I would hope that, like, you know, my beard was a little longer and, like, my hair was, like, a little less, like, polished looking, right? Like, mm-hmm. I want to look like a traditional, like, Muslim-looking man, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's like, let me give you a better example. I shouldn't even said that, but it's all good, whatever.
Yeah, like, for example, like, what he's talking about is, like, we're not allowed to talk about our sins. Like, you're supposed to keep it internal. It's a private thing. We're not supposed to talk about it.
Let's say I was, like, a woman, right? And I was giving advice, right? Mm-hmm. I like this advice. I was just, like, I don't know. Let's say you go to a masjid or wherever, right? Or, like, you have, like, a local, like, Muslim, like, I don't know. Let's say some schools, I guess, probably have, like, a Muslim sister kind of association thing that they do, yeah, or whatever, right? Imagine, like, the person who, like, was, like, the president of that was, like, a woman who doesn't wear hijab and stuff, and she's giving, like, you know, these lectures. I'm not saying.
It's like, no. It's like, I wouldn't listen to somebody about podcasting if they didn't have a successful podcast.
Yeah.
Or I wouldn't listen to somebody about business because they don't have a successful business. You know what I mean?
True.
It's like, it doesn't make sense. Like,
yeah.
For me, like, I'm dumb and they're also a lot of times.
Yeah, like, why would you want to listen to
that? It's a lose-lose situation,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
I wouldn't say it's just lying, though. I wouldn't say it's just lying.
But lying in a sense, it's not like lying. It's more like, I feel like, kind of like, you don't have, like, an actual story to tell, like, a relatable story to tell, right? Like, when you confront somebody about anything, like, it could be school, life, anything like that, you want to have trust that person that they've dealt with something that you haven't, and you want to conform in them to have a conversation so where you gain something and that person also gains a happiness and that person has been helped.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And I think that's, like, that's exactly what you're kind of growing into, right?
I just want to be my best self. I don't want nobody to make mistakes and be like, well, you know, Wiki does it, right? Or mom, like, this guy does it. I don't want nobody to be like, oh my God, mom, like, I follow this guy. He's, like, always giving me, like, reminders on TikTok or YouTube. And then they're like, oh, like, what? But he shaves his beard or something. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm not saying I do. I don't shave my beard. But I'm just saying, like, right, for, like, the Muslim influencers who do stuff, right? Or, like, oh, well, you know, yeah, if I'm, like, I'm not saying I do, but, like, okay, let's say there's, like, a guy who, like, drinks every now and then, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's a Muslim influencer and he did whatever, right? I don't want someone being like, oh, mom, like, they came home on a Friday night drunk as hell, right? And then there's, like, well, their mom's like, bro, like, what are you doing? Like, you know? And they're like, well, you know, like, this guy on YouTube does it, and I look up to him, and, like, you know, I watch his stuff, and he's a good Muslim.
I had a similar conversation.
Because it normalizes, like, the stuff.
No, I get what you're trying to say. I had a conversation with somebody, like, actually before the podcast, like, a different of Christianity about this. So, that actually, like, I understand that now, because he told me that. And when you're saying it now, it kind of makes sense, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
I think it's mature on your end that you actually think like that, you know what I mean?
Because
there are a lot of liars. I feel like in all fields, there are a lot of liars, you know, people that don't kind of, like, have, you know, the courage to kind of say, like, oh, I'm actually doing something wrong. Instead, they're just going to perceive themselves as, oh, they're the good guy. Oh, they've been doing this. And then when they get exposed, it's like, Like, I'd rather expose myself in the now before I build a real audience compared to, like, you know, getting exposed.
Yeah, people will take you as a role model, like, whether you like it or not, if I think you're in that kind of, like, area of, like, how you do things, right? People will take you as a role model whether you like it or not, and I'm not saying I want that, but whether you like it or not, and if I was going to be someone's role model, I would want to be a good role model. I just don't want to be that one.
And I wanted to get into this because you were talking about it. Like, kind of talk about both of y'all, like, I guess, journey to faith. Because, again, like, I'm going to explain this, and everyone on the, like, talk show and every, like, pod should know about this, like, you know, we live in America, not, like you said, godless, kind of, like, not a very, like, a morally good standpoint place, like, you know what I mean? Like, you can get about, you can get anything, any wrong thing in this country within 10 to 15 minutes.
Yeah, 100%.
And especially, we live in, like, a very, like a prominent city, so, like, we live next to D.C., so, like, we can probably get, like, literally anything within 10 miles.
You want to tell them my address, too, bro?
I want to ask y'all like a little bit about like your journey to like faith. I would say like how did it start from you? Did it start from a young age or did it start from like?
I prefer my friend Abel. I think it's more beautiful coming from him.
I understand.
He's a well-spoken man.
I appreciate that, but I will gladly. I could talk about this forever and ever and ever, but basically, grew up in a Christian household.
Mm-hmm.
Went to church. I even went to a Catholic school from kindergarten to third grade.
You're lying.
I swear. Yeah. So I'm very familiar with the Christian religion, but I'm not gonna lie. I wasn't the most religious growing up until high school. Like I didn't really. I believed in God, but I did not believe in religion. I was very confused in the fact that me personally, like, I'm not even here to judge or question anybody's faith. But me personally, I just didn't believe in Jesus himself being God. Mm-hmm. So I was confused, and I didn't really know much about Islam. But I would see my friends and how strict they would take it and how they loved it so much. I said, yo, it's beautiful. So I always had this interest. And then I'd say, like, my sophomore year of college, when I was still at Nova, before I transferred to Tech, I was gaining a slight interest in it. But I wasn't sure. I was like, nah, I couldn't be a Muslim. I couldn't change my whole life, you know? Yeah. I don't know how my...
It's a tough thing.
Yeah, it's a tough thing. And my family would react in a different way. React in a bad way. I didn't know. I was very nervous about it. So I kind of like stepped back, but I was still doing Tzom for the Orthodox to do. I did that.
I'm doing it right now, yeah.
Mashallah. Mashallah. But yeah, I did that for 3 years. And then once I transferred to Tech, I had all this time to myself. I had a lot of time of reflection, a lot of time to think and learn. So while I was alone, I started to gain even more interest. I used to ask my friends, like, Wiki was one of them. He is one of the main reasons. He's a good reason why. Like, he would teach me a lot. I would ask my friends, like him, one of my friends, Tariq, Abu, Riyad, Idris.
Shout out all my heads
and yeah, my niggas and stuff a lot. But yeah, I would just ask my friends like simple questions and ask them, how do I do this? How to do that? What is the belief with this? And then slowly but surely, my faith was just getting stronger and stronger, and I believed I wanted to be a Muslim.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, now I'm here. Now I love it. I'm glad I made the decision.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like it's just, there's no cons to it. I'm just happy. Yeah.
Being from an Abisha Christian household, how was it? How tough was it for like you to tell your parents kind of this information?
It was tough. It was very tough. At first, I didn't even want to tell them. Like, I entered the crib, and I was just like so nervous because there's no Muslim in my family, so like I didn't even know what they would react. But I mean, I ended up telling them, and obviously, you know, you would guess what their reaction would be. Like, they feel weird about it, but like at the end of the day, like, I'm family to them. I'm their son.
Yeah.
You know. So, I mean, over time, I don't know. They just got used to it, you know. Like, but it was weird, and I was definitely scared. And I understand why a lot of people would be scared to even consider changing religions because it's a whole different change. The whole family's got to get used to it. Yourself has to get used to it, you know? But yeah, you could imagine what it'd be like.
Yeah. Wiki, I wanna ask you, so you're kinda you're kind of like growth into like your faith. Like, when did that start, do you think?
So I mean, like, as a kid, like, I grew up, like, you know, my parents would put me in like, you know, weekend Islamic schools, like, you know, study programs and stuff. I always like grew up around
Do you think you can put the mic to me?
Because
I feel like that's not like the camera's sound.
Put
yeah.
this over here?
Yeah, it's by putting in the middle so like both you guys.
Like this?
Yeah, exactly.
Gotcha.
It's
happening.
Okay.
Alright. Yeah. My bad, I probably messed up the mic.
You're good.
But, okay, so, yeah, growing up, like, I was, like, my parents would put me into these, like, weekend programs, like, Islamic weekend programs and stuff. I even went to, like, Islamic private schools for, like, a very short period of time. Yeah, like, as a kid growing up in America, like you said, they, especially when you're a young person, your brain is very, like, you know, you're very easily influenced by things. So growing up, like, I'm going to school and they're teaching me, like, you know, in public school, right? They're teaching me about, like, you know, it came from, like, monkeys and, like, fish or whatever, like, you know, evolution mm-hmm. and, like, all this type of stuff. And they're teaching you about, like, these, like, sciences.
Different ideas about life, right?
Different ideas, yeah. And they kind of push it to you as if it's, like, a fact. And, you know, then I go to, like, my weekend Islamic programs and stuff, and it's, like, they're telling me the exact opposite, right? Like, and, you know, there's, like, this negative kind of association with Islam and certain Islamic societies, etc. And, you know, it's, like, Islamophobia. That's
yeah, exactly.
Thing. So, growing up, not to be, like, and put this, I pretty much thought, like, I knew better than, like, this religion and stuff as a kid, kind of, at a certain point, like, not in the beginning, like... Mm-hmm. Obviously, I'd say, like, between, like, from up until I was maybe, like, 10 years old, I was, like, for sure, like, yeah, Islam is true, like, nah, whatever. But then after you get, like, around that age, I would say, like, 7th grade-ish, I was kind of like, eh, like, is it true? I don't know, like, you know, like, it could just be mythology, right? Like, they teach you about Greek mythology and stuff, right, in school, or, like, Roman mythology, whatever. And then,
I don't feel like a lot of people, do you think a lot of people believe in that stuff, or, like?
Well, Greek, no, that stuff's, like, basically dead. But what I'm saying is, like, but, like, when you... As a younger person, I was thinking, like, what's the difference between, like, Greek mythology and, like, Islam or Christianity or something, right? Mm-hmm. It's, like, these very far-fetched sounding, you know, like, stories of, like, gods and, you know, miracles and stuff. It's, like, what, you know what I'm saying? Like, and it's very limiting into, like, what you, you know, like, it gives you an idea of, like, what to think. And what you should be doing, and, like, what's good and what's bad and all that. And it's, like, for example, like, I'm not gay, but, like, if I was a gay person, right? And you're a gay person, and you grew up in, a Muslim home or a Christian home, right? In America. And you're going to school, and you're learning about, like, all this stuff, and, like, you know, like, evolution, all this type of stuff. And, like, you learn about, like, how previous nations believed in their own, like, mythological religions, right? Mm. It's, like... Am I really gonna not be gay just because, like, God told me not to? And, like, is God real? You know what I'm saying?
I think, but that's, listen, and I wanna argue, not argue the take, but kind of, like, in my own, like, mythology with this thing. I kind of feel like the influences this country specifically is given to, like, us, like, especially at a very young age with, like, social media and, like, the internet popping off, like, basically when we were young. Like, I do remember a point where I didn't have, like, Wi-Fi, or I wasn't using my phone or whatnot.
Yeah.
And it was, like, after, like, maybe 10 years old, I was, like,
yeah.
It was a regular thing, you know what I mean? And there's, like, I feel like there's, like, a lot of benefits to that, but again, there's a lot of defects. And I'm not gonna lie, personally, for me, regardless of how much I take advantage of this, I feel like the defects are more than the advantages.
I agree.
I strongly agree. The amount of things that are accessible that weren't accessible beforehand is so crazy. And I wanna get y'all points on, like, do you feel like America, do you think, like, okay, obviously, like, you couldn't, like, say, oh, if I grew up here, it'd be better, but, like, in your own opinion, do you feel like you growing up in America probably had a big reason on why you guys became the people that you were, or even before you guys changed your faiths?
I mean, for me, I felt like, so I just kind of became more into my faith. Like, I just thought one day, and I was just like, yo, does this, like, stuff, like, I just started thinking more about, like, I started thinking more day to day. And then I started thinking, like, yo, what is, like, really good with life? Like, what is this world? Like, where did all this stuff kind of come from and stuff? And so I had these big questions that I actually wanted to think about now, right? Instead of just, like, living my day, like, oh, like, I don't know what's...
You didn't learn the fact that, oh, I might, like, feel something in my head, but...
I have to think about, like, I don't know, I just thought one day, I remember just, like, one night just thinking, like, dude, like, where did everything come from? Like, and before, it's, like, whenever I would have doubts, it's, like, okay, maybe it's not true, maybe it's not, whatever, but, like, my family's Muslim, and, like, whatever, I'm gonna be on that, right? But then I started thinking real hard about it, and then I was, like, I started looking for these answers and stuff, and started reading a bunch of different books. Like, I read the Quran, I read the Bible, like, I read a bunch of different, like, you know, like Hindu books, like, read the freaking, like, Bhaktivedanta Gita, like, you know, like the Vedas, like,
I don't even know
what
that is.
Yeah, no, yeah, but the Hindu, hey, if anyone's Hindu and watching it, they know what I'm talking about, right? So, like, yeah, like, Buddhist books and stuff, like, I read, like, everything, just trying to figure out, like, what's true, what's not, like, what is the meaning of life, whatever, right? Like, where did the world come from? Started looking into, like, you know, like, the Big Bang Theory and stuff. Like, I started thinking about, like, what everything is.
Like, you just went into, like, a big kind of, like, journaling research phase on
that. I just had to read a bunch of stuff, took notes on a bunch of stuff and all that. And I was like, yo, Islam is true, you know? And so I started getting more serious about that. Growing up in America, I don't wish I grew up in America, but here's the thing. There's money here. That's the truth. Like, you feel me? There's, like, politics that go into that. Why is America richer than, like, you know, Africa or, like, the Middle East or, like, Asia?
That's a story. Like, that's a conversation we could kill, like, 2 hours on this podcast.
Yeah, that could take, like, you know, forever. I can't even answer. There's people who've, like, studied this for, I don't know how long, for sure. But, so, as far as, like, I'm glad I grew up in America to a certain extent. I'm glad I grew up in America and didn't lose, like, I guess, yeah, like, Islamic, like, I'm glad I still have, like, Islamic values, I guess, while, like, even though I grew up here, because it gives me an opportunity to, like, take the advantages of growing up in America and, you know, using that to my advantage and my family's advantage or whatever. But, like, I think it's very hard, like, there's Muslims who, like, there's people who grew up in America. It gets to the point where it's like, I'm not saying people, like, this is America, people are allowed, like, they're, like, by law, they're allowed to do whatever they want,
right?
But it gets to the point now where it's like, I might meet a person, right, who's like, has a very obviously Muslim name, and I really have to ask them, are you Muslim? Because it's like, I don't, you know what I'm saying? You don't really know anymore. Because like, people be like, yeah, I'm Muslim. Like, and it's like, what, you pray? It's like, you know what I'm saying? And it's like, what do you mean? Do you not pray? And it's like,
it's like a lot of questions that you're like, it's like almost like your name, your family's name, whatnot doesn't matter anymore. Like, oh, this is what your religion means. At one point it did. Right?
No, I mean, like, it's like, people will literally just, like, people will, like, I've met people who literally identify as Muslim strictly because, like, their family identifies as Muslim, and it's like, you can ask them, and, like, they literally don't even believe in Islam, like, you know what I'm saying? And so what I'm saying is, like, I think that's a danger that comes with, like, raising your, that's, like, a bigger danger that happens here if you raise, like, you know, Muslims who, like, raise their families here, whatever. So I'm glad I got the opportunity to, like, get a better education here and, like, you know, have money opportunities.
I can say, based off one thing he said that America does have money, but I think the thing with that, like, I think you can agree, like, that makes people in America, like, only worried about money, and they'll do anything for money. 100%. Even the horrible things, like, they'll do anything for money. And that's one thing that separates America from different countries, like, and back to the question you asked prior, like, me growing up in America, I mean, yeah, like, I was once a part of the Matrix, you know what I'm saying?
Like, just the system. That they've trained us in this
world. Yeah, basically. I've been a part of it, like, I just started coming out of it a year ago, like, I mean, like, I don't blame anybody for being it, because just the way we've been taught, the things that we've been conditioned to do, I used to smoke, drink, fornicate, do all these things, like,
And you're young,
but I think America has a big role in that, you know, like, they just normalize it and they're okay with us doing all this shit.
And I feel like it's, I don't know, I want to get a Bell's take on it. I feel like it's kind of translated to the rest of the world
to an extent.
In a sense, American culture is kind of like now looked at. Obviously, I feel like if you're like a, you know, out of the box type of person, you would kind of tell, like, oh, this stuff is like bad, wrong, whatnot. But like, for somebody that, you know what I mean, that doesn't really know too much, it's like, oh, it's cool to smoke, it's cool to drink, it's cool to, like, do this, you know what I mean? You know, leave shawties and stuff like that. And it's like, to be honest, like, we're, like, you know what I mean? As men, like, we've all, you know what I mean? We've
fallen
before.
Exactly.
We're not perfect, you know? But it's like, I wanted to kind of get your take on that. Like, how do you feel? Like, do you feel like it has made an effect on the rest of the world?
100%. I mean, you see, like, I feel like it all stems from America, but, like, I'm not going to sit here and act like other countries are perfect, you know?
Yeah.
Because every country, everybody... No place is perfect, but I say America is, like, the number one culprit.
It's like, so, the king of the
third. The king of all of it, basically. Yeah, like you said. But, yeah, like, but I'm not going to put it at fault, because, I mean, it really just depends on an individual person. Like, it's not just, everybody has the chance to just step out of that box, you know? Yeah. Like, everybody can just realize, they have to step out that box and realize what they're being conditioned, like, being taught, you know? So... type shit.
I don't want to raise my family here. That's all I'll say. I definitely don't want to do that.
Like, my plan is definitely to get, like, just, like, abuse, like, the privilege I've had of, like, growing up in this economy. Like, taking that and moving somewhere else into a Muslim society. But I don't know, but it'll be a Muslim society.
What about you? Do you have a location in mind?
Muslim society, either a Muslim society or at least somewhere in Africa, bro. I don't know.
I would love to.
And it, like one thing I want your thoughts. Like, everything in America, like, is everything sexualized. Do you agree?
Yeah. I agree. In a sense, like, what do you mean?
Like for example, people.
Sex
sells. I feel like if you walk down the street downtown DC, there's a girl wearing something revealing. They're gonna be looked at as an object.
I'm gonna be honest with you, and you know, my take is gonna. I don't think it's gonna be rough, but I think it's gonna be realistic.
Go ahead.
I think, men and women, the way things have been looked at is so, like you said, sexualized.
Yeah.
And I have a couple of takes on this. I would say the access to pornography.
Yeah.
I would say that
horrible.
That's the probably one of the biggest effects.
Yeah.
Instagram, social media.
Yeah.
Accessing women on that as quick as possible. I think the dating game is completely corrupt. Like, the fact that, like, our parents would have to go out. Our parents would have to go out of their way. Like, our dads would have to go out of their way.
Yeah.
Go out with their buddies, you know? And just, like, go smack that shawty.
Yeah.
I feel that's much better. Like, I respect that.
Yeah.
Than if a guy's going on IG.
And just...
Yeah, right. The thing is, I don't even like. It's not like the prone that. It's like a fake world. Like,
yeah.
That girl is showing something fake. This guy might have a nice photo or two, but he might not even have any emotion going.
Yeah.
And it's like, as a man, it's like it gets to a point, and I feel like I've come to this point very young.
Mm-hmm.
It comes to the point where it's like, now in my head it's like. I think I was watching this one TikTok video, and the guy was basically saying, like, you can fake it for so long.
Yeah.
For only so long. It clicked with me. Because a lot of...
No cap.
No. Because the thing is,
no
like,
cap.
People will literally fake their lives, right?
Yeah.
On social media and whatnot. People will believe it.
Mm-hmm.
People will believe it.
Now this guy...
Social media...
I don't believe it.
Listen, no.
I believe it 100%. I know people who have complete... It's like two-faced, two different personalities. It's so horrible.
And it's like social media has became the new world.
Yeah. People prioritize that internet world over the real world.
I'll tell you something. From somebody... That I would say beforehand, I started doing all these works, like started like doing my podcast, my talk show, and all that. I would be on my phone, maybe just like on social media, geeks with friends and whatnot, but not too much. The amount I use social media, I looked at my track record. I use my, but this is for my business purposes only, so I know that I'm doing it for the right cause.
Yeah.
But I'm on my phone on average 13 hours a day.
That's you crazy. Know, I don't blame you.
But the thing is, let me tell you something. I absolutely think, like, when I'm, like, I need to take breaks. Like, sometimes I'll be, like, doing posts or something like that. Like, there'll be a match going on, or I have to post, like, this TikTok or something like that.
Yeah.
Right after I finish it, I just put my phone away. Like,
yeah.
I don't even want to be near it.
Yeah.
For just a cool 30 minutes. Because, like, even though I know I'm doing it for something,
yeah.
That stuff, like, bro, just looking at that screen, looking at that type of stuff, it's, like, so... It's like, I don't know, it's like a virtual punch, bro. A virtual punch, like, you're always, like, fighting. And especially for somebody that's not using it for anything and they're on it for that long.
Just for bullshit. They're just looking at shit that just does not matter. Entertainment, you know?
Like, I think people want to be loved. And so it's like, people want to be accepted by other people so bad that... Sometimes
it's like Instagram is like high school, dog. Like, I swear to God.
Yeah, exactly. Why do people want to be popular in high school, right? It's like popular or whatever. It's like
the next girl.
They just want to feel.
Yeah.
Just want to feel loved by people and like whatever. But it's like
it's
if you don't love yourself. You know what I'm saying?
If you don't love yourself. Oh my God.
If you don't
it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who loves you. If you don't love
yourself.
Plus, most love is like it's pretty superficial anyway. Like it's like I'm not saying okay. I mean, like
talk about high school love.
No, I'm just saying, like, bro, like, the social media love you get, or, like, even that, like, oh my God, like, bro, that, right, if you're, like, that girl who's posting your cheeks out on, you know what I'm saying, on Instagram and stuff, like, come on, be, like, I want you to really think about this, right? Like, I'm not saying this, oh my God, like, I'm not trying to,
like, no,
that's
why he's right.
It's like, listen.
The guy who probably,
I'm gonna go on my Instagram tomorrow. It's gonna be like deleted. You know, listen. So, I'm just saying, like, if you're that girl, or even a guy, right, who's, like, trying to, like, look like, I don't know, like, you're trying to be freaking young boy or some other dude, little baby. You're trying to pretend like you're a little baby or something.
Yeah.
Right? Or you some girl, you want to pretend like you, I don't know, Kim Kardashian or something, right? It's like, I'm just letting you know, like, whoever is, like, showing you love, that dude or that girl, whatever, who's showing you love in your DMs or, like, whatever, even in real life, like, you gotta really ask, do they really love you, or, like, do they just love, like, what you, like, represent to them, like, kind of, you know?
Like.
Yeah, what you look like, what they think they can get from you,
yeah,
and stuff like that, right? Like, yeah, if you a dude and you flexing a bunch of money, right, it's just to, like, get some girls, like, does that girl love you, or is she
you know what's crazy? You know what's crazy? And, you know, I'm not, I'll definitely, like, I'll say I'm like, I feel like I'm a materialistic person. Like, I definitely like the nice things in life. I'm very honest, I'll be honest with you.
Yeah.
I want the nice things in life. I try to do those nice things. But, like, I definitely think men do, like, I would say to an extent, it comes, I'll personally say this on my end too. Men aren't flexing for women. Men aren't flexing for women. Men are flexing for other guys. No, 100%. They want other guys to let, they want to let other guys know that they're better than them.
That is true.
That's true.
That's
my fault. I think
that's
you know what I was gonna say was
that's,
really, yeah,
that's true.
Spirit. But like no. I definitely think that it's not. It's mostly not for girls. Girls don't really care. But I don't think like put like this, bro. I think the right woman wouldn't care. The right woman.
Yeah, the right woman. But majority of women.
It's America.
I'm not doubting that they don't get an extra, you know what I mean? They don't get an extra, like, step ahead with girls if they have money and whatnot.
Yeah.
But I think a lot of guys, like, and I feel like I've seen a lot of, like, success kind of videos. A lot of successful people kind of have this, like, toxic motor. And
yeah,
it's like, they're always, like, they never felt like they were fitting.
Yeah.
You know what I'm trying to, I was like, they were very, like, Elon Musk, like, bro, bully as a kid.
Yeah.
Then he became, like, you know, billionaire status, all that Jeff Bezos. Guys were, like, geeks, nerds, you know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
And it probably was, like, hated on. People didn't like them when they were young and stuff like that.
Mm.
I feel like successful people have, like, that type of motor. That's why they can keep going, even if they reach $1 billion, because it's like,
yeah,
who goes after $1 billion and keeps going, you know what I mean?
Do you feel like it's exaggerated, though, the way that they, like, explain how they are and how different they are? Like, for example, Elon Musk saying, oh, I didn't fit in, I was bullied. Do you feel like they're just exaggerating?
I want to say this. I have my point on this is everybody's been bullied to an extent.
Yeah, everybody.
We've made fun of to an extent.
Yeah.
We've made fun of, literally making fun of each other is how we grew up, right?
Yeah.
And eventually we just had to grow up from that stuff, or we maybe had to find it out, or we had to argue it out, or you know what I mean? We just learned how to deal with it as men, right?
Mm.
But I think the difference between a man that's not successful and a man that's successful, a man that was successful, literally was willing to do anything it took.
Yeah.
Forget the bullying, forget anything.
Yeah.
I swear, as a man, if you tell yourself, right, let's say you're doing a TikTok, you say, I'm going to do this for 5 years. I'm going to post every single day for 5 years.
Yep.
If you do every day for 5 years, forget 5 years, bro. Within 2 years, you'll make it.
Even less.
Even less.
Yeah.
But again, the mentality that you had 5 years is going to put you on top of so many people.
Yeah.
Because now so many people are just kind of like, I'm getting like 2 days, like 3 days, you know
what
I mean? Like, let me blow up, blah, 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 like that.
So why do you think that people give up so quick? Do you feel like it's a confidence issue? I feel like it is.
Personally, for me, for somebody who's, Wiki knows me, I kind of like, I go through hustle. Like, I always like try to like make something new. And this is actually the first time, I would say, of any project.
Mm.
And I've started other things on the side too,
mm,
that have been completely consistent for multiple months. And
yeah,
I continue to be consistent for years till I die. Like, I want to be successful, right?
Yeah.
But I would say the difference between me at the first time when I was doing things and starting up to now I don't care. I literally don't care what I have to give up on obviously on an ethical moral sense, I definitely care, you know what I mean? I'm not gonna like kill my morals.
Yeah.
But when it comes to like, let's say if friends are just like, oh, let's link every day and stuff like that, and I'm not willing to link, I'm okay with that.
Yeah.
If people are like, yo, Samson, bro, what's happening, you change and stuff like that, as long as I know I'm good, and my real friends know I'm good.
Yeah.
That's all I care about.
You're changing for the better.
Wiki will tell you, like, you know what I mean? He rests my case. Like, when I do now, I try to better everybody.
Yeah.
That's how I operate. Because it's like, I now have the fire in me to, like, I have to take over the world energy now. That's,
mm-hmm,
and that's how I'm going with things. So
mm-hmm,
until I win, I don't give up. I'm not quitting.
I feel that.
I feel like that's the only way to be successful when it comes to this, especially content creating. I mean, if you stop, obviously, you're just not going to make it. If you keep going, at some point, you're going to find an audience. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
At some point, there's going to be somebody who finds this shit, oh, this is interesting. And it'll, just like you said, it'll take less than 2 years. But so it's a good thing that you're changing. And people are going to want to link you all the time, want to do these different things that you're just, that are going to, what's the word?
And I said, I tell people this, don't, like, I want to say, like, go, like, ghost mode, just, like, don't, like, oh,
yeah,
this
yeah,
is a name, right?
Yeah.
But be smart. if you know you have an assignment to do, or you have, okay, you need to, you have to edit this thing, right? Mm. And somebody tells you, let's link for only 30 minutes, don't be dumb.
Yeah, no problem.
You never link for 30 minutes. I've never linked a person for 30 minutes in my life.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be honest.
And then it, yeah, facts.
I've never linked anyone for 30 minutes.
Facts.
If you tell me to link, that's just a no, dog.
Facts.
The person that says no goes farther than the person that keeps saying yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes men never win. Yes men never win. And men that can't say no never win.
Yes men never win. That's a good
what
point.
What if I'm a maybe man?
You won't win either. You won't win.
Okay. Yes men never win.
But let me ask y'all, like, you kind of, like, going back, like, the question that you asked me, I want to, like, reverse it back to, mm-hmm. like, do you, like, first of all, when it came to, like, men and, like, when they, like, flex money and whatnot, what do you feel about that? Do you feel like that's a flex to girls, to other men on the sense, like, they're better than them, or, like,
what you think?
That's not my question.
I bet.
I'm asking you too, bro.
I bet. Always, I think. Okay, when it comes to money, that's definitely obviously it's for both. But I feel like that's definitely to flex on other niggas, like other men.
Yeah, for sure.
Just to make it seem like you're so big and up there, like it's like an ego boost,
mm-hmm.
you know. And at the end of the day, I feel like the people that do that the most are the people that are the most unhappy. Or the people that just need reassurance in some way. Like, why are you flexing the money? What's that going to do for you? Just to get more likes or more people to think that you're a big dog? You know what I'm saying? Also, like, yeah, it's a flex for women because there's a lot of women out there. I'm not saying all women, but there are gold diggers.
Oh, my God. What? You just said that? Yo,
there's gold diggers.
As a representative of the women in this world, we got to cancel this guy. This guy is taking
it too far. There are so many gold diggers.
Yeah,
I will stand on that.
Women are beautiful creatures, and you need to respect
women
them.
Women are beautiful creatures, but you can't lie. They're gold diggers.
Bro, as the pick me in this podcast, I will say that. Like,
this nigga's just a simp, bro. Yeah. This nigga's simping.
Hey, but nah. Life for simps.
Hey, bro. But nah, I know, like, I don't know. What's your thoughts? Because I believe that it's for both, but.
Let me ask Mr. Trollman right here. He has all the answers to this.
Mr. Trollman.
Alright, listen, guys.
Yeah, who is this guy? Bro? This guy's like, it's like an NBA press conference.
All I have to say is this, right? Listen.
Look at the gaming for this guy. All
right.
Hey, you're supposed to do it
for me. I got you.
I have to pay me for this. I'm not with the AJ part. Find my DMs. Samson got
I'm
you.
I'm trying to get multiple spots in the band.
It's right here. You can find me somewhere down below in the link. Okay. In the box down below. Some, I don't know what they say. I need to, okay, anyway. You'll find my stuff there. Dear Park, hit me up. I will sponsor you. I mean, if you give me money. But if not, beer, water, is buns. All right. Anyway.
Yes, sir.
Gotta feed the family. Anyway. So yeah. As I was saying. Okay. What was the question?
What are your thoughts on money?
Do men flex money for guys?
Listen. Okay. I think it's definitely like some men. I think it's like, it's a spectrum. Some guys do it more for the girls, some do it. Let me put it this. I would never, ever in my life flex for another man. Like, honestly, I would never do that. I wouldn't even really do that for a girl. But, like, if I was a man who was trying to finesse a girl and I had evil intentions, I would definitely use my money to, like, try to do it. But, like you said, it's like, I would never flex my money if I really liked a girl, because then, you know what I'm saying, I'm trying to see, like, she really likes
me.
We
talked about this a couple days ago. You were just kind of like, never in my life, right? And I found this fascinating for, like, a young kid, and I was like, never in my life have I ever wanted to be, like, another person.
Yeah.
He said that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because it's like, because...
You never thought that in your life?
You never just wanted to, you never looked up to somebody.
There's people I respect for sure, and, like, I admire qualities that they have, but I've never been like, damn, like... Bro, I'm about this. How many people have you seen, like, and you can definitely tell they want me little baby so bad. like, I'm not trying to be nobody else. Like, I like myself. Like, I really, like, think I'm cool as hell. So it's like, why would I want to be you? Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm about this. The guys who do that and they go on flex on Instagram, or that girl who does that, whatever. I'm not saying 100% of the time is for, like, they just, like, I just think a lot of times people do these type of things is just because they want to feel important to other, they want to feel important, they want to feel loved, right? And it's like, if you do things to try to, like, you will never get the love of everybody. Like, right now, I'm sure, like, whoever watches this is going to be some people who are like, yo, that guy's cool as hell, like, you know what I'm saying? But there's a bunch of people who are going to be like, yo, this dude lame as hell, you just talking all this, like, bro, whatever, like, he lame as hell, right? But I'm not doing things for them. Like, I'm not even doing things for the people who like me. Like, I'm literally not. I'm just doing it, like, because of me. Like, it's what's in my best interest. So it's like, if you love yourself and you care about yourself and you take care of yourself, you can depend on that. You can rely on self-love and like the love of God, right? You cannot rely on other people, because one day they're gonna be mad as hell because you didn't do something they wanted you to. Or like,
I think though, like understanding that everybody will fall on you one day.
Exactly.
And then like you understanding that, okay, if everybody's gonna fall on me one day, who do I rely on? Yourself and God. There you go.
So I don't want your love. You don't see me on social media posts like trying to, like, I'm not trying to flex, like, especially not for no guys, like, what? Like, yeah. You can't give me nothing that, like, I really care about. Like, if I have enough, like, stuff for, like, myself to take care of myself, like, I'll be Gucci, like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I'm a man, and, like, I like women, but, like, it's like you said, like, and put, like I, it's like I said, like, yo, like, if I'm flexing money to you as a woman, like, you should, not just me, I will say this generally speaking, if any man ever flexes money to you, if you're a woman, he's probably just trying to get in your pants, like,
because it's a red flag. It's a red flag.
Going into like the money, like, you know, like flexing and whatnot. Like, I want to get y'all perspectives on like what you guys kind of want to do, like when it comes to like furthering your either your religion or either like success and whatnot. Like, do you guys have a blueprint of like where you want to be? Let's say in, like 5 to 10 years, because. I think that's really important. Like, you know,
yeah, I go to school. I'm trying to like get that stuff out the way. Trying to like have a good career. I'm trying to get into like tech and stuff.
Are you passionate about it?
Not really, but it's gonna pay the bill. Like, I'd assume like if I get good at it, it'll pay the bills pretty well compared to like. Like I said, I can't be a rapper or anything, because like Islamic stuff, I just don't.
Yeah, that's something I want to do. Shout out Chunks if you watch this. If you ever get to watch this, but yeah, he said he stopped. I think he was an artist or something, and then I think he quit because, like you said, it was a good situation.
Yeah, I believe it. It's like, I want to create something. I want to create a career for myself that like I can be what, and it's like, you know, like it's within like my religion to like it's okay for me to do that, right? Mm-hmm. So like. Ideally, if I could, like, I would just be, like, a freaking Muslim teacher, or, like, an Arabic teacher or something, like, one day.
You can
day,
get
but, like,
money. If you could get the equivalent money in IT, you
probably Yeah, but it. It's, like, that's not, you don't get rich, like, teaching people, like, Quran, you know?
But I would disagree. Like, I can tell you right now, like, I'll put this. I literally used to use a math teacher on YouTube, like, just, it was, like, for my calculus class in when I was at Nova, my first semester. You know that guy had, like, a million subscribers on YouTube, and all he does is teach his math.
And he makes how much?
I don't know how much he makes, but I'm definitely, he doesn't make monetization.
I'm not saying it's impossible. I'm just saying
if you genuinely think outside the box, I think you could genuinely.
I would
you can make more money being a teacher than you could being IT. If you could understand how to like monetize. Sure.
So like, I definitely. But here's the thing though too. It's like part of it is like. Ideally, I just want to do something that's like within Islamic topics and stuff, and like do that for a career. But like.
Are you scared to take a risk into?
No, I'm still definitely gonna like. I'm gonna plan on doing that for like volunteer. Like, I don't mind like volunteering at like the local masjid one day if I'm like very like good at what I do and like teaching people whatever. Like, that's definitely something I plan on doing. Like, and I want to like marry a girl who does that too. Like, wants to do that too. Right, and just like go to the mosque and like teach like little kids like freaking like, you know, like how to respond and stuff. Like, I don't know, but like that's not you know. Like, that's not like something that's like I don't know.
There was a distraction, that's why he left. There was a distraction.
Anyways, but like,
there was like beautiful like cat that just like.
Bro, yo, Wiki, bro. Cut. Anyways, what I was gonna say was that, bro, within 5 to 10 years, where do you see yourself in, when it comes to like either your career or like your TikTok or whatever? Yeah. You wanna grow that into different social media platforms?
Yeah, so right now I'm just starting on TikTok because I feel like it's the easiest way to get viewers and like start an audience, you know? But like, right now I'm about to graduate from Virginia Tech, get my bachelor's in public health, and then inshallah I get accepted to Mason to get my master's in global affairs. And the reason I'm doing all this because I was never really interested, or not interested, but like I didn't really want money to be the focal point in my life. So, and I was, since like early high school, I've always just been focused on or really interested in just helping people and traveling the world. Nice. So I stuck with it, And once I'm done with school, I have this YouTube channel that I start. Oh, yeah. I want to start a YouTube channel.
Yeah.
And then, my bad. But I start that, continue to grow an audience. And then as I go into different countries, I vlog my experiences, vlog me helping people, me the different projects that I do, project implementation, stuff like that. And hopefully I can collab with other YouTubers.
Absolutely.
And then I feel like the money will come with... Hopefully, you know what I'm saying, but yeah.
And you, I also peeped that you want to, you're doing Arabic, you're going to be starting Arabic.
Yeah, oh, you people comment?
Yeah, of course I did.
Appreciate that. Yeah, I just started because, like, as you know, I converted to Islam, and I really feel like it's necessary for me to understand the holy book, the Quran, like, in Arabic, so... Yeah, now I just started. I don't really know much yet, but like I've memorized the alphabet, trying to get to know words, you know. Mm-hmm. But I'm starting from the ground up, you know.
And you know, actually, Wiki's actually he's learning Arabic at the moment too. So like, what advice would you give him? You know, when he's starting his journey or not with the language.
It's like I don't know, just like look at it like how you look at school. I guess like you just make sure you're consistent with like you know, just do your work and. Make sure, just honestly, I'll say this actually. Whenever you want to like learn a different language, I think good advice generally, whether that's Arabic or Spanish or anything, right? Is one, I think you should definitely have a passion for that, like that language that you're learning.
One thing I will say though, you remember in high school how bad I was with French?
Yeah, because you didn't have a passion.
Passion also, but I don't know, even I have a passion from Hark as well. But like I just feel like it's just so difficult to learn a language. Maybe
think,
it's just
there you go. I wanna cut you off. Nothing is difficult.
True.
Nothing is difficult.
You're right, bro.
Like I don't wanna be like, bro, I'm not like
you're right.
I'm not a successful person. Like I tell people this, like I'll be like, I'm not a successful person. But what I realize is, bro, with the amount of years, if you do it enough, bro, you'll figure it out.
I think when it comes
life to is about problems and figuring out the solution.
I think when it comes to learning a language, right, it's like one thing that's like good just advice that I don't think a lot of people just like get sometimes is that like you should try to make that language like a part of your life as much as you can. Me and Abel both took French in high school, and you were both like really bad at it, right?
You took French in high school too. I passed that class thing with a B or A for 3 years, and I know two words. Je m'appelle.
Yeah, exactly.
Come to Paris.
Yeah,
that's the only two things.
That's because you just tried to like pass the class. You weren't really trying to learn French.
Yeah,
though.
It's like almost like we're cutting corners to get the
exactly.
Yeah.
So what I'm saying is like, if like when I was taking French classes, if I was just trying to pass those classes, I wasn't like actually listening to like French stuff in my life outside of class or like reading French books and stuff like that, right?
Yeah.
But like if you learn a language, you should kind of be like, think of it as like, this is something I want to be a part of my life. And so you should try to implement it into your life as like where the chances you get, like whenever you get the chance to, right? Like speak it wherever you can. Like if you know someone, oh, like this guy speaks this language, or right?
Yeah.
This guy speaks French, like I'm going to speak French with him, right? Like so that way.
One thing about me though, I'm very shy. Like if I have to speak a new language, bro, I'm like scared to fuck up. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I would agree. I picked up my Marina probably like last year. I'm pretty decent. Wiki used to be my biggest hater, but
so what, you think you're like fluent now or like?
I'm humble enough to say I'm not fluent, but I made gains. Would you say I made gains?
Yeah, so here's what I was saying too, right? It's like, people. I'm hard. No,
he's ear.
Yeah,
okay.
I guess.
But
I have more money than you, by the way.
Anyway, so I would say like when it comes to that, it's like it kind of can be shy, especially if you're like a beginner, right? Like you're like probably like, oh, I don't know too much Arabic right now, like I don't want to speak.
I've been in front of like fluent speakers too, bro.
People appreciate it though. People appreciate it.
Nah, bro. I agree with it.
I went to Ethiopia this summer, and bro, it was so I was there for 2 months. And the locals, when they see me, they automatically know I'm not from there, first off. Second off, when
I crazy. They know our parents.
I don't know how
they know our parents are from. They live here too.
I was talking to a friend about this literally the other day. They say it's like based on like, I guess when you're in Ethiopia, you're burnt. Like I guess the sun just be making you darker. But
you have a struggle face.
I guess that's
true. Struggle face, yeah.
I swear. But also, what's it called? When you open your mouth, they are judgmental as you could be, bro. So judgmental. So
okay, but there, I'm saying, I'm not saying like, if you go to Saudi Arabia and you don't speak Arabic, well, like, I mean, they probably prefer to speak English with you.
Yeah.
But like what I'm saying is like,
and a lot of countries have kind of converted to English. I'm not gonna lie, they didn't realize like, bro, they're not gonna progress as a country, bro, if they don't like pick up English.
And what I'm saying is like, okay, like for example, I'm just saying, even regardless, right? Hey, regardless of how people feel, like if you have anybody in your life who you can like speak that language with, you should try to do it. Listen to like videos in it, or like I don't know, like do stuff. Like bro, like my all my contacts on my phone are saved in Arabic. Like you know.
And what I'm saying? And I've actually, I'll tell you this. I watched like an Ethiopian podcast.
Really?
Ethiopian podcast
in full heart.
Yeah, because I realized music and comedy can be a little bit tough because there's a lot of slang. Like even with that music, like
true.
You slang. Can't imagine somebody from a different country
couldn't.
Listening to Lil Baby. And
yeah. No.
But I would say podcast, just like kind of vlogs.
Yeah.
Vlogs I vibe with a lot, and yeah, like shows, the shows and stuff.
I've
like
heard that,
that
people.
Those three help for definitely beginners. I recommend.
Yeah.
I think music and like comedy is for our parents. Like, that's
yeah.
Like,
because they understand
like,
the
hey.
Whole. Yeah.
And
yeah.
You'll get better. Like the more you like implement it into your life, the more you're willing to just like. That's what I'm saying. You were never good at French. Me and you were never good at French, right? Because one, we didn't have really passion for it, right?
Mm-hmm.
But like, regardless, it's like outside of French class, I'm not getting any freaking French like
yeah.
into my life, right? I'm
mm-hmm.
not putting any like I'm not using French ever. I'm not listening to French ever, like whatever, like
yeah.
outside of that classroom, right? But like, if you use it as much as you possibly can, like you'll get
big
decent
facts.
At it, right?
Facts.
Like, let me put it like this, like. Sensei could probably tell you, right? Like, okay, like, before, you probably didn't know. You probably couldn't speak anything in Amharic, right? You probably understood it.
I would say my Marina would, like, to the point where I probably knew, like, maybe 30 to 40 words. That's not
okay.
Right.
Okay. Right. Okay, but so, right. like...
And not even improperly. Like,
but
Wiki just, like, humbled me. Like, you knew, like, how
yeah.
bad my Marina
yeah, was. So, my point is, like, when you started trying to take it more seriously, right? You probably just started speaking it more, right? With
mm-hmm.
your family?
I would say, yeah, speaking it more, and also... Writing and reading. I think writing
mm-hmm.
and reading for language is the first step.
Yeah. yeah.
Because the well, I think I realized I was just my like watching this on YouTube a lot. But I think it's like English, right? We learn A B C D,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
We learn A B C D, then we sit at writing, then
mm-hmm.
we just start talking.
Yeah. That's what
so like
is.
Learning
as
language
like,
learning,
is the same thing.
Learning a language is like four skills, I think. It's like reading skills, it's writing skills, it's like listening skills, like understanding what you're listening to, and then like speaking skills.
Yeah.
These are all kind of like separate skills in their own like way. So it's like, someone can like understand a language very well and not be able to speak it at all, right?
Yeah.
It's because they basically have been practicing like the listening skill for so long, right? Which is probably like you, right? Like when
yeah.
you couldn't speak it, right?
You
still
like,
understand
yeah.
it, right? It's because you're constantly listening
speaking
to the language.
Yeah, yeah.
So like you understand it, but you can't speak it because you haven't practiced the speaking skill.
Mm-hmm.
But once you start actually using that speaking skill that you do have and working on it and trying to get better at it,
yeah.
it gets better with time. So it's the same type of thing. Like the more you listen and speak and write or read, right, the better you'll get like at the language and all those aspects. If you only listen to Arabic, you'll never be able to speak it well, but you'll be able to probably start to understand it,
yeah,
right?
Exactly.
But what do you feel like you're more passionate? Like which language would you like rather be fluent in, Arabic or Armenian?
Dang, that's
Arabic.
Tough. Nah.
I know it's a tough question.
That's a tough one. Because Amharic is like my home country, but Arabic is my home religion.
Oh, yeah.
That's hard, bro.
Yeah,
that's hard, bro. I don't know. I would want to learn both at the same time, but if I had to, probably be Amharic just because I'd be able to speak with my family, you know?
You can, like, bro, it's like.
It just feels good, you know? But I don't know. Hopefully both. But nah, facts. If I get those four down, I feel like I'd be able to.
And so, it's not like something.
Did you say you're fluent for the week?
What?
Arabic
or
Arabic?
I think
Arabic
is definitely.
If I can be scaled out of
10. I mean, like, English is the only language I would say I'm like fluent in.
For sure.
That's the thing to all say this about fluency, right? Fluency is this thing where it's like you think of it as like, oh, I'm fluent now. Like I know everything in the language. Like it's not really like that. Like you'll always have gaps. Like. Even now, like, right, I'm in school sometimes, and, like, the teacher will say a word, and I'm like, what does that mean? Like, and I speak English natively, like, to my first language, right?
The complexity of the words, yeah, it's always going to be, there's always going to be a more complex.
Always things you're not going to really know, but, like.
When it comes to regular conversation,
yeah, like,
you met an American man, we can have a 5-hour conversation in English. That's not
like,
a problem.
Yeah.
I don't feel like, let me put this, like, if I have moved to, like, you know, I can, like, speak Amharic a little bit, too, right? So, like.
You think you survive in Ethiopia with only Marina? Like,
if I lived in like an Arabic speaking country or like Ethiopia, like an Amharic speaking area in Ethiopia, I think for sure I'd be able to like live. And like I would say my Arabic is better than my Amharic, but like I don't think like I'm still like an English speaker first, so it's
yeah.
like if someone talks to me, they definitely know like you know what I'm saying? I have gaps in, like, my... Like, they'd have to dumb everything down for me.
For sure, yeah.
But, like, I'd be able to communicate with them. It's not going to sound like...
And I'm not going to lie. Right all the time. I'm not going to lie. It really, like, that takes me off. Like, when, like, somebody, like when they know you don't know money, them, they just kind of, like...
Yeah.
Like, that kind of is, like, bro, like, nah, I got to learn.
Just ask them. Like, I do that all the time. Like, sometimes, like, I'll go chill with my, like, my family, like, my cousins who speak Arabic and, like, my aunties and stuff. And, like... I have an auntie who, like, literally doesn't speak a lick of English, right? So it's like, I have to speak with her in Arabic. Like, yeah. So sometimes she'll say a word and I'm like, what does that mean? And then, like, they'll just give me, like, a synonym that I do know in Arabic, right? And I'll be like, oh, okay, like, okay. You know, now that I have another word, I just, like... That's what I'm saying. You got to implement it in your life as much as you possibly can, right? Like, whenever I have the opportunity to, like, speak really in a setting where, like, everybody will feel comfortable, like, you know, being around it. Like, I'll use what I know, right? Like, whenever, like, I'm not really trying to learn Amharic, but, like, whenever I do see someone who, like, speaks Amharic really, like, well or whatever, like, I will try to, like, just, like, I'll try to speak Amharic with them, right? Or, like, yeah, same thing, like, if someone speaks Arabic, like, I'll try that, too, just because, like, that's how you get good at it. You just gotta keep trying.
It's like basically implementing it in your
If you're, like, shy and you're, like, oh, like, I'm not good at Arabic, or I'm not good at Amharic, or I'm not good at Spanish, or, like, whatever, right? I'm not gonna try because I don't want to sound stupid. You're not gonna get there.
I feel like the better you get at Arabic, the less shy you get with it. I feel like
that's true too. 100%.
It's just consistency, bro. But like the thing with me, bro, like if I feel discouraged or I feel embarrassed, I will with certain things, especially languages, I'll just give up and then I'll be like, okay, I'll try again in the future.
Also,
and
that's a really bad thing. If it's not a serious, like a very serious thing that you're talking about, like obviously, like if you're like. If you're talking to some dude who speaks Arabic and like it's like something very serious that you're really talking about and you just need to be as clear as possible. I'm not saying go and just try to speak Arabic.
Yeah.
Like if you have a little, like, you know, you only speak it a little bit, right? But like if you know he speaks English, but I'm saying like if you just have a friend who like, or like, a, I don't know, like, yeah, I don't know. Like if you have a friend or somebody you know that just like speaks Arabic, I'll say Arabic's a little hard though too because like it's not like there's so many dialects and stuff and like a lot of people who you will see who will say they speak Arabic. They don't really speak like Arabic. They speak like, you know, like they're like, oh, you know, my family's from Syria, so like they speak like Syrian Arabic,
mm-hmm.
And they can't really speak to you. They can't really speak to you in like proper Arabic, right?
Mm-hmm.
Especially if you're in America.
Mm-hmm.
But if you do know somebody, like you have friends from the mosque, or like you just know somebody, right?
Yeah.
Like yeah, like you know, like me, right? Yeah. You're like, yo, like we're just talking about something random, like, hey, you want to get some food, right? Like you could say that to me in Arabic, and like you know,
ask
like,
them,
whatever.
Yeah.
How the thing, to use it.
And the thing is, like with the language thing, I feel like. Even when I think about it, it's like I want a woman who wants, who knows about it fluently. I want my kids to know about it now.
Wallahi.
So I have to sacrifice whatever, you know what I mean? Whatever, you know what I mean, is shame, embarrassment, and whatnot, to figure out this language through and through all, move to Addis, and then be able to conversate, have the language basically memorize, read it, everything.
Wouldn't it be a tragedy for your kids not to know Mark or know anything about
Ethiopia? I literally think that is one of the scariest things I think about.
I feel like now
if
Ethiopians like our generation, if we stay in America and just forget about Ethiopian culture, they're just gonna be, I mean, it's not a bad thing, but like black Americans, there's gonna be it's not a bad thing.
I had an Ethiopian deacon on the podcast, on my talk show a couple episodes ago.
Mm.
He literally told me this and it crushed my heart. He said Amarina is a dying language.
Oh,
and I was like, but I thought about it and he was like, bro, like, who's teaching Amarina? And I was like, okay, I know one class that's teaching at UMD, but it's like, Amarina or Spanish? Amarina or Arabic?
America,
I don't even heard Arabic is low-key a dying language.
Nah, well, never, like,
I think,
the class of, like, class
way,
of Arabic has been the
like,
same.
Like, because all your generation, bro, do you know how many people are in England, in Europe?
That's
in,
okay,
but
okay,
there's a lot of us have moved on. Like,
it's not my people who live here, right? But
that's a lot of the population of our of the religion.
Okay,
the
if you are somebody who's like, you know, from whatever country, whatever culture, right? And like, for even like Hispanic Americans, right? Like, Spanish is like basically the second language in America, right?
Yeah.
But like, I remember I saw like this one thing on like Pew Research or something one time. It was like, yo, third generation like Latino Americans, like a very large, like I think the majority of them actually don't speak Spanish anymore, right?
Third generations in this country.
Yeah, so like someone who's like grandparents were like immigrants to America. Like Latino people, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like some. I like
could agree to that.
Majority of us speak
by the parent, because the parent was American. Yeah.
And Spanish is an easy, like, is a, like a lot easier to like pick up if you're American, right? Than like if you like want to pick up Amharic, right? Or like Somali, or like, you know, like whatever Arabic or like.
No, I think it depends on like, your environment. Like, if you're around, if you're okay, probably this. As me, as an Ethiopian man, me learning Spanish would be much more difficult than me learning.
I think
it will, yes, because,
yeah, it would.
Because I wake up in the morning with a Habesha mom, Habesha dad.
Exactly.
Habesha
yeah.
Yeah,
but like,
I don't have to.
Like,
I don't have to go out of my way to talk to anybody in the morning.
What I'm saying is, there's so much Spanish content that's out there. There's so much like opportunity to use.
Bro,
it
but at the end of the day,
the content doesn't matter. It's the people that you're around.
It's
your
surrounding.
You can easily find like Spanish, like Hispanics, like you know Spanish.
But he's literally he lives.
Most of my friends are Habesha as well. So for me, it's not difficult to.
That's a choice you made.
Huh?
But anyway, okay, anyway, my point is this
type shit.
My point is this though, right? People generally try to assimilate into the cultures that they live in. Like you said, it's like, oh, like, you don't want, like, you, like, I don't know, like, people who speak Amharic or whatever, like, who, like, you know, like, they, you don't want people to lose their culture when they're here, right? Lose their language and
right,
stuff.
Right.
It's like, if they cared about that, they would prep for that. But, like, you have to understand, like, a lot of... Yeah, like, okay, that person right now whose parents, like, immigrated from Ethiopia, right, to speak some Amharic or something, right? Maybe, like, you know, like, you, for example, might be like, yo, that's important for me to speak, like, my family to keep speaking Amharic or whatever, right? But, like, that's not everybody's reality. Like, a lot of people don't care. Like, they see, a lot of people, like, do, like, consider themselves American, like, before any of those other things, right? So it's, like, to them, it's, like, whether... Like, about this, like, for you, it's probably important to, like, have a Habesha wife and, like, you speak Amharic with, you know, family and stuff, right? A lot of, like, dudes like that who are, like, whatever, they might not think that way. They might be like, yo, like, they want to be a little baby and they want to, like, you know what I'm saying? They want a girl who's, like, you know, African-American.
But,
and
you know,
they're okay with that. They want to assimilate
that.
That
disappoints
that.
Me. Especially when I see, like, an Ethiopian kid, like, not trying to, like,
yeah.
at least, like, of course, like, you don't have to be, like, too crazy about the culture. You don't have to, like, do everything, but it's, like,
yeah.
Like, at least not trying to recognize your Habesha. But trying to lie to yourself and say, like, oh, like, this is, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm with this people, you know what I mean? I'm not Ethiopian. I don't believe in that, all that stuff. It hurts, because it's, like, then I know their children are going to be a part of the dying generation.
Well, that's what I'm saying. You can go to Ethiopia, though, and go to freaking, I don't know, some Amharic-speaking area, right? Like, I don't know a place, but... Gondar, right?
Yeah, yeah.
You can go to freaking Gondar, and, like, yeah, people speak Amharic, right? So it's, like, bruh, like, they're still going to be there. They're just going to be where, like... their homeland is like.
But
it's America.
Know,
like, this is not an Amhara state. Like, you see what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, I know.
The day, it's like,
there's still gonna be a new generation in Ethiopia.
Yeah, they're still gonna be there. Like, if these people assimilate,
yeah,
and
no,
we have a big problem. We're at 100 mil plus by the way. Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm saying, like, bro, like, people are gonna want to assimilate. Like, I'm by this, the person whose family has been here, like, let's say you have, you know, you marry an Amhara or whatever, and like you guys have kids and like, you know, whatever, and like, this is like, oh snap, like this is like something that happens, like, you know. This is something that's important to your family for, like, generations, right? Maybe 5 generations later, like, your kids are going to be like, dude, like, I'm American anyway. Like, my family's been here for, like, 500 years. Like, I don't even know anything about being Amhara or Habesha or, like, Ethiopia or nothing like that, right? So it's, like, to them, it just seems like this, like, arbitrary thing that's just, like, in their family for no reason. Because it's, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, You don't even. It's not like you know like what the streets of Ethiopia are like or anything anyway, right? Like, it's like, so to them it's like, I am American. Like, I only know American culture, right? Like, so it's like, I don't know. Like, I see what you're saying. I know what you mean. It's something, but like, they're there. Like, those people are in Ethiopia. Like, go to Ethiopia and you can stay with them and live with them, and like, you can have that for you and your family, right?
Yeah.
But I'm saying it's not reasonable to expect like a kid who's like. Think about this, like, if I raise my kid in America and they're like, yo, I want to be with a white girl, and like, you know, like, who's like...
The odds of that are much higher, is what you're saying.
So I'm saying, not only is it much higher, but like, you have to be willing to accept that. Not just accept that, but like, that is the norm. Like, you
so
should be
accepting
people
that accept that.
My parents don't, like, not accept that. Like, they wouldn't care. Like, I don't know.
Your parents wouldn't care if you married a white girl?
No, my parents wouldn't care. Like, bro, I've had
I swear they would care. I promise they would care.
I've had marriage
talks
with women
they would
from
care.
Like literally every place in the world. Like, I've talked
you
to like Somali girls,
buy,
like Bengali girls.
You brought
like,
Stacy to the
No. My parents wouldn't be cool if she was like, you know, like really, really like, you know, like.
Hey,
I don't want to say.
I know what you mean.
Like, if she's Muslim, right? If she's Muslim and she's like. She's Muslim, right? I think that's the only thing my parents.
That's
true. I get that.
Like, if she's Muslim and she actually practices Islam, it doesn't matter if she's like American, like, you know what I'm saying, like a white American person. Like, my parents are gonna be like, oh my god, like what, like.
What do you about? Do you feel it's the same way for you? Or?
I feel like for him it's different because his parents are Muslim, so like.
Yeah.
Like it's really just.
I don't think we're very like. Ethiopian Christians, especially are your parents Orthodox, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so we're very conservative. Yeah. As conservative as Muslims, to be honest.
Yeah, no, we are. Yeah, we are. But my parents would definitely feel some type of way if it was a white. I don't know.
I feel like maybe for you guys, like, okay, I don't know about you, but, like, I think maybe more so for you because, like you said, you're Orthodox. You're, like, Ethiopian Orthodox specifically, right? Like, you guys have a specific church that is, like, built around, like,
our religion and our culture at the same
nation,
time,
right? And these type of things. And, like, you guys have a certain, like, culture and stuff that goes with it, right? That kind of intertwines with the religion, right? And so I would say maybe in that case, yeah, because it's, like, what church are you guys going to go to, right? Like, if she's, like, freaking, like... Yeah, she's, like, a white American, like, Baptist girl, like, right? Mm-hmm. It's, like, are my kids going to go to, like, the Baptist church, or are they going to go to the Ethiopian church, right? Mm-hmm. And, you know, you want them to fit in and all that stuff with that, and, like, that community and not feel pushed out. Because it's, like, yeah, I know she, like, I see where it comes from. But, like, yeah, I'm just saying, like, me personally and for my family, it's, like, I wouldn't, I'm not, like, oh, my God, she has to be from, like, whatever, she has to be, okay, remember this, I want my wife to speak Arabic for sure, right, I want her to know Arabic really well, just because, like, I want my kids to, like, and I'm probably gonna move to, like, an Arabic-speaking country one day anyway, but, like, I want my kids to grow up in that environment just so, because it would be so much easier for them to, like, you know, for, like, religious purposes, right, but, like, if she's a white girl who spoke Arabic, I wouldn't look at her any differently than if she was, like, you know, from Sudan.
Like, if she spoke Arabic. I wanted to ask her, like, now, the situation with Shah is, like, do you feel like at this age, like, you guys are trying to, like, are you guys trying to, do you feel like you're trying your best to control yourselves when it comes on the aspects of, like, you know, trying to be more holy around women?
Of course. Halal thing.
I respect that.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, now it's just, like, I feel like now, like, it's just a time where we realize we're getting old and we're getting to the point where it's time to marry soon.
Man, you know? Really?
I mean, maybe it depends on the person.
Who wants AIDS?
I
don't want AIDS. You want AIDS?
What's marriage age for y'all?
Whenever. Shit, whenever.
Bro, I met the right person
the
right
second
now.
You got in college, the time
I'll get married right now if I met the right girl, bro.
I swear.
But
really?
I'm passport boys though, so like respectfully, like I'm probably gonna just get married in a, like a different country. But if I want, like if I did meet the right girl here, which I don't think is likely, but if I did, then I would get married right now if I could. Like,
what about you?
She was with it, like I don't
know. I would say like 30 to 35 is my range. Like
wow.
Again, like but I feel
dude,
like,
I mean I get
okay,
it.
Okay, for
it.
Me, I'm like I'm Christian, I'm Orthodox, so like I feel like. Even in, like, our culture, the Egyptian culture, like, our parents probably got married around, like, late 20s, going to 30s.
Yeah.
Maybe latest, like, 35 and whatnot, but yeah. I don't think, like...
I don't think that's a cultural thing, though. I think that's just, like, a certain people who do, like... I don't think it's a cultural thing. I think it's, like...
I definitely feel...
It kind of is.
People who marry young and people who marry older.
The thing is,
right?
I would say in the Muslim community, from what I've seen from, like, friends that I know that were Muslim, a lot of their parents married very early.
Very early.
Like, 21, like, early 20s.
Yeah. It's, like, recommended to get married as soon as you can. Like, I guess they just... I think the main reason, you could correct me if I'm wrong, is to just keep you away from all the bad things that could happen if you were not to be married.
Want
to
get married, yeah.
Yeah, but...
It's a good thing in general, though, too. Like, I've heard, like, hadith. I don't know, like, the gradings of them. I don't know if it's, like, sahih or, like, hasan. Right? But I've heard, like, I read a hadith one time that was saying, like, even the prayer of, like, a married person is, like... It's just better than the prayer of, like, someone who's not married, right? And it's a lot of things that go into it. Like, being married... It protects you from a lot of, like, evil and stuff, corruption, right? Because, like, you got, like, a lot of dudes, right, will literally, like, bro, do so much, like, just dumb stuff just for, like, some, you know, some play, right?
Yeah.
And it's, like, if you have a wife at home and, you know, you're happy with your marriage and all that, and you're, like, you're really satisfied with it and all that, right? You're not going to be out here, like, doing dumb stuff, trying to fight dudes outside of a bar at, like, 12 o'clock on a Friday night, right, or
yeah.
something.
And I think...
To look good in front of women, like,
I swear,
you see what I'm saying? Like,
I swear, no.
I'll make your life easier.
Not to change the subject, but, like, I actually think, like, when you were saying, like, fighting and stuff like that, like, I remember one time, it was, like, recently, like, you know me, somebody just, like, you know, they're, like, oh, let's, like, fight, we have, like, an issue and whatnot, and I actually, like, I was, like, I just kind of looked, like, I looked at that person kind of crazy, I was, like, bro, I haven't fought in, like, so long, I'm, like, bro, like...
Have you ever gotten in a fight? Like
For sure. Yeah.
Oh, yeah,
like,
yeah.
Like, as a younger kid, definitely, yeah.
Yeah.
But like, bro, like, now, like, bro, I feel like fighting is, like, so, like, just young, like...
It is a young thing, bro, because if you can't control your emotions, if you can't...
If I had a friend, right, and they, like, wanted to fight me, like, obviously, I'm a man, like, I'm not gonna let somebody, like, press me, obviously, but it's, like...
You try to stop it first.
Yeah, bro, yeah. It's, like, I don't know, I just find it kind of, like... Like, young, it's really like,
childish.
Kind
of childish.
Because, like, we're older and, like, you have things to, like, actually worry about.
No, bro.
Right? You want things to, like, you actually, like, when I wake up in the morning, I'm not like, damn, who can I fight today? I'm like, dude, like, how am I going to progress in my life? And, like,
yeah.
How am I going to make today good and, like, progress in life? And, like, right? It's not. So, Yeah, I don't know. It's like, how about this? I think people who are like fight more and like stuff like that.
They don't have anything more from
themselves. They have less to lose. They feel like that. Yeah. They feel like they probably have less to lose and stuff. People who like want drama and like to fight and stuff like that. They just probably feel like they don't got like too much to lose.
Have you ever gotten in a fight?
Yeah, but like
a fist fight. I mean,
yeah, for sure. But like,
have you
got? I don't think I've ever gotten in a fist fight. Like man. Squaring up, never.
Yeah, but like, when I was like, I don't know. I haven't fought nobody.
You feel like you've gotten to a fight with that before?
Yes, I could have. Obviously, like, I could have gotten in a fight, but I just didn't. I don't know why. I'm not gonna lie. Like, I want to get in a fight in my life, just to like. I mean, just once in my life. Like, I just see a nigga. Like, let's be real. You see a nigga get knocked out. Imagine if you knocked a nigga out and he was talking mad shit to you. Wouldn't that feel like? That's so funny. I swear to God, I would knock. Never mind. Never mind. But yeah, I've only gotten in like
altercations. Like, literally, after you fight, even if you win, it's
yeah,
like,
I said,
my hand hurts now because like you punch this guy in the face and like your hands.
When y'all get in like an altercation, like an argument, do y'all be like feeling bad right after and apologizing or not?
No.
Because that's what I
think. I think for like this, it depends on the situation.
It's crazy.
I think, bro, I think nowadays I don't even have like, I don't have, first of all, the tolerance. Like, I come in like a very peaceful manner. If you know me, anybody in my viewers, I'm a very like, I'm just like a fire. I just want to geek, maybe talk sports, talk like life, or, like, you know what I mean? And like, just keep it pushing. I really don't have any memes. I'm not trying to fake anything. I know who I am, and I live the life of who I am, right? But like, for me, like, I swear, at this age, for somebody for me like to actually fight, like, you actually have to like, you have to physically hurt me.
Yeah.
Physically hurt me,
yeah.
To be honest. Yeah. You actually have to like touch me, bro.
I literally like, I don't even want to argue with people, like, respectfully, like,
I don't have that dude.
If you make my life harder in any way, like, if I literally
you have to
like,
cut that person off.
If you give me like any mental stress, like, and you're not worth like the like my wife can probably give me mental stress, I guess, I don't know, but like my family can, my dad, my mom, my like, you know what I'm saying? But like, if you are not someone who's like worth the mental stress, like as a friend, even like any, like I'm just simply not gonna like continue speaking to you. Like I will literally just remove myself from like the.
Have you ever dealt with a situation like that where you've had to do that yet, or like?
Dude, a ton, like not all the time, but it's often. Like, bro, if someone asks me something stupid and like, or just something, they're just stressing me out. Like, I'll just like, I just check myself out. I'm just like, yo, like. You know, I'm not getting paid for this. Like,
I'm not gonna lie. I know it's like from both you guys. Like, I know Wiki very well, and I think I know Bell like roughly well. I've met him.
Yeah.
We've talked a decent amount of times, but I feel like you guys come in like very mellow like vibes. Like, I feel like you guys like, like you guys like I said, when it came to like somebody would have to like physically like hurt me to like for me to be like have an altercation.
Yeah.
I feel like I definitely have like a tendency where like I can base somebody sometimes, like if they like really give me like
yeah
or whatnot, like
yeah,
in a conversation obviously, right? But
it's
that's only with close friends though.
It's crazy. I can't even imagine you like getting mad. I don't know why. I can't even imagine.
For me to get mad, like somebody would like again, somebody would probably have to like disrespect like my family or like somebody like I genuinely
just blatant disrespect.
But,
I feel
like, if you're like disrespecting the Lakers, like bro, I'll get mad at you. But I'm
that's
gonna,
nothing.
Like,
nah, that's
I'm
nothing.
Gonna, I'm gonna like live life, like bro. It really doesn't disturb me, right?
I'm not gonna lie, bro. When the Eagles lost the Super Bowl, niggas were clowning. I'm an Eagles fan.
Yeah.
They were clowning me so bad, pulling their phones out. I swear to God. The thought of swinging actually crossed my mind because I was so mad.
I swear.
But like it shouldn't be that serious. But I get you. Like, it should be something blatant disrespect where you get in a fight.
I want to ask you, do you guys feel like you've always moved with mellow vibes? I think I'm pretty much mellow vibes too. I feel like, but I'm just saying, you guys, like, I'm going to be honest, I've seen Wiki not like be disrespected, but I've seen Wiki get screamed on and just him just like, not Wiki. Wiki is not a very, like, I wouldn't say Wiki's somebody that tolerates, you know, kind of like somebody to disrespect them, but like, I would say you definitely kind of like.
He's not a hothead.
Yeah, bro. You're not a hothead.
Yeah, I mean, bro, like.
You think that's always been the case?
Definitely not. I've like definitely been a hothead at certain points in my life, but like, I just learned, like.
Each other for a while.
I've just learned in my life, like, yo, like. Just like doing, like sometimes I'll even get back, like you said, kind of like sometimes I'll like someone will just do some dumb stuff. I'm just like, yo, what if I just slapped, like,
I swear,
why don't I just do that? But then I'm just like,
it doesn't make sense.
I'm like, that's just not the right thing to do.
Yeah.
Like, and I'm just like, it's not even that deep. Like, literally, I can just literally just walk away.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know what I'm saying? I can just walk away.
Yeah.
Like, if it's not gonna like ruin my life or like hurt, I'm not gonna get hurt, or like my family's not gonna get hurt, or like somebody like here with me, like with my friends, something like that is not gonna get hurt. Like, I'm just gonna, people are, like, stupid. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I think a lot of people are, like, really just stupid people.
Yeah.
So, like, honestly, when people give me problems, I'm just like, damn, like, that's crazy. And I just, like, you know, move. Because, like, I'm like, oh, wait, what am I getting from this? But, like.
Do you feel like that's how you move in the situation, too? Or, like.
Yeah, I mean, pretty similar. Like, I'm not gonna lie, like, back, I'd say, like, high school, bro, I would be a hothead over little things, especially basketball. Even to this day, when it comes to basketball, that's like the main thing that gets me heated.
Yeah.
If I get a turnover, if I pass the ball out of bounds or I miss shots, I'd be screaming. Like, it's really bad. Yeah.
Unfortunately, due to the phone dying, we had to shut down the pod early, so we didn't get the full footage, but we pretty much got everything. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. I hope this one was a banger. Like, share, subscribe, all that. Link down below. Samson Dollar Show, we're out.